श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। देर इज अ ग्रेजुअल ग्रोथ इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हेन वी टेक अप्रोच टू लाइफ इन ए मेथोडिकल मैनर। द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज वी आर कॉट अप इन दिस वर्ल्ड आउटसाइड, so from there to come out is the first step. And what is that step? The step is this world has always been like this, and we are in this world for our evolution. Like we go to the school or college for studying and growing wise. In the same manner, we are sent by the Lord in this world to learn and grow. Those who refuse to learn, they never grow in life. They grow old, they don't grow wise. So, we come out of our obsession for the world. Then, now, we should not become self-centered alone. So we are told that as long as you are dependent on the world, you must lead a responsible life. And there the principle of dharma comes in. Principle of dharma tells us that you should respect your parents, मातृ देवो भव पितृ देवो भव आचार्य देवो भव अतिथि देवो भव। लिव लाइफ इन दिस वर्ल्ड नॉट लाइक एनिमल्स बट लाइक ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द एनिमल्स एंड द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स? एनिमल्स आर लिविंग ओनली फॉर देयर एग्जिस्टेंस, दे हैव नथिंग मोर, लाइक सोसाइटीज, लाइक पेरेंट्स, like the brothers and sisters, nothing of this sort. Ahara, nidra, bhaya, maithunam, four are the only pursuits of the animals: eating, sleeping, security and procreation. Beyond that they cannot go. So if we are human beings, we should not limit ourselves only to these four, but lead a social life of self-discipline. That is called as the dharma. Thereafter, we become well disciplined and attain some control. See, when a very nice lawn is seen by a buffalo, she doesn't care. It is a thing to be eaten. Whether there are nice flower beds, marigold flowers, beautiful, the buffalo will come and start grazing over, because pashyati iti pashu, the one who sees doesn't think. But if as human beings we start behaving that way, why encroach on somebody else's territory? So it's not right. So we are told about dharma. Then next step is our life is not limited only in the gross body. Because the moment you start thinking, thinking is based on the cause and effect relationship. And what is the cause and effect relationship? A cow or a buffalo or a bird never ask any questions. Therefore, they are beyond cause and effect. And we have nothing but questions. So we are caught up in the cause and effect. Now what are our inquiries or questions? why there is so much of disparity in this world, why good people suffer and bad people enjoy. See, what was that because of which I am having such problems? These are the questions. Now, if you are told you are responsible, we will not accept it. I have never done any bad to anybody in my whole life. So we are told, yes, you have not done in this life. In the earlier life, who knows what you were? Oh, I must have done it unknowingly. But the effect comes knowingly. So a new area is now inaugurated. What is that? We have got out of the world, came at the individual level. From the individual level, living in the present body, that we have discarded. Now we have entered a wider horizon of existence. That we existed before the body was born, we exist in this body, and whatever we are living, we have to account for it in the next life if we don't behave properly. Now the canvas is wide enough for these people who have accepted that whatever happens in life, I am responsible. So I must change myself. Now what is changing ourselves and what is being responsible is that I have to do lot of punya karma, meritorious acts. I have to do a lot of charity. I have to do a lot of austerities. Yajnodana tapakarma pavanani manishinam. When I do all these good things, then I go to the higher worlds. Where do you go to heavens? Oh good. What for? You don't know. No electricity cut, no bills, no problem of Pizza Hut, nothing. Because no hunger. What a lovely thing it will be. And we want to get it and go to the higher realm of existence. But mister, please remember, you cannot remain there all the time. Then kshine punne. When all your balance is over, you are pushed back to the same matunga. Come back to matunga. And thereafter, again the same old story. Now, this is in between step. This is not the final truth. But this is such an enchanting thought that we get stuck up here. And such people who get stuck up here, they are attracted towards the path of yoga. They are attracted towards the path of karma. They are attracted towards the path of devotion. I want to go to Golok. I want to go to Saket. Go to Delhi. There's one Saket. I want to go to Kailash and stay there in the presence of my beloved Lord. What will you do there? Look at Tukur, Tukur, Tukur. What next? Think. The one who is not enchanted by these stories, he is called as Nachiketa. Nachiketa means, Nam is not. Chiketa means Chipakta. The one who is not attached to the relative existence. And such a Nachiketa asks a question to the teacher. Anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat. Anyatra asmat krita kritat, anyatra bhutaccha bhavyaccha, yat tat pashyasi tadvada. ओ लॉर्ड डोंट फ्राइटन मी विथ धर्म अधर्म righteousness and unrighteousness. Don't frighten me with the sin and the merit. Don't tempt me to go to heaven and hell. I don't care for that. Don't catch me in the cause and effect. Third, don't frighten me with the influence of time. Tell me something beyond all these three. And to such a person who is no more interested in the relative existence, to him to instruct the truth is this in-between state. Now what is the in-between state? He has to know that what he doesn't know first. But that what he has to know cannot be known. See? आश्चर्यो वक्ता कुशलोस्य लब्धा आश्चर्यो ज्ञाता कुशलानुशिष्टा. इट इज द वंडर ऑफ ऑल वंडर्स दैट द स्पीकर हु कैनॉट स्पीक अबाउट द ट्रुथ येट गोज ऑन स्पीकिंग अबाउट द ट्रुथ इज इट नॉट. एंड मोर वंडर इज द लिसनर द श्रोता ही हु कैनॉट अंडरस्टैंड येट ही गोज ऑन अंडरस्टैंडिंग. आश्चर्यो वक्ता कुशलोस्य लब्धा. Therefore, in between step is this topic which we are taking now. So what is the in between step? As the other day I told you, an unknown is assumed, taken for granted. Suppose the value of such and such thing is X. So what is X? X is unknown. Like ex prime minister, isn't it? Ex colonel, ex brigadier, unknown. So yesterday I met one ex police officer in the squirrely sea face. He came, did namaskar. Swamiji, I said, yes young man, no I am a VRS, I am old one, all X's. Therefore, X. Now, when I don't know something, I assume as X. Then I deduct. After you deduct, you have to arrive at the value of the unknown parameter, is it not? Suppose you have been given data and the unknown is assumed to be X and you write the reply. Therefore, the reply is X, isn't it? Will you get any marks? No. The same X will be taken a big X and totally wrong. In the same manner, this unknown reality is pointed out to us through the assumption of knowledge. Now, what is that? The teacher says that are the eyes seeing for the sake of the eyes? No. There is someone behind the eyes. Very good. Are the ears hearing for themselves? No. There is someone behind the ears. Now there are five senses. So are there five fellows inside? No. There is but one. Not five. So who is that one? Find out. Now the inquiry sets in. And to tell this, Bhagwan Sri Krishna says that mamai vamsho jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatanaha manashashtani indriyani prakriti sthani karshati. My amsha means aspect. An aspect of me. See, electricity tells, the light aspect of me is manifested through Ballab, isn't it? Ballab Acharya. Through the bulb, the light aspect of me is manifested. the magnetic aspect of me is manifested through the fan. So only light and magnetism, these are not the total expressions of electrical energy. They are just few of millions possible. In the same manner, one aspect of me, mama eva amshaha. So what are many aspects? Many aspects are objectivity, subjectivity, relationship, appearance and disappearance. See? So one aspect of me, mama eva amshaha, normally when we hear this word amsha, that doesn't mean that there is a, you just take one grain of Paramatma and that grain of Paramatma has become Jivatma. No. In Vedanta, when the students learn in the initial stages, they are told outside is the Annamaya Kosh and like a layer inside is the Pranamaya Kosh. And inside is the Manomaya Kosh, inside that is the Vijnanamaya Kosh, inside that is the Anandamaya Kosh, inside that is the Paramatma. So they start doing meditation. Positive Kosh. See, there is such a fun on the spiritual path. So amsha does not mean an iota. So mama eva amshaha, an aspect of me, jiva loke. Now jiva loke, the technical translation is relative existence. Loka means experience. See, just lok. Isn't it? Yad gatvana nivardante. Narayana, I see every day, no? That's what I read. So, loka means experience. And what are the experiences which trouble us? Experience of relativity is a big problem for all of us. In the deep sleep, the experience of relativity disappears. And therefore, we are all happy. In absolute existence alone, there is a guarantee of absolute bliss. In the relative existence, there is a guarantee of relative blisters. Forget about bliss. So, jiva lokaha therefore means at the relative existence. So, an aspect of me manifests as a relative existence. Now, what is the relative existence? I versus you. See? I remember one poem long time back, one girl wrote me after marriage. After marriage, many people turn poets and poetesses because, you know, they get inspired out of frustration. All poets are basically frustrated, and that frustration is glorified through words, is called as poetry. So that girl wrote me, Swamiji, it is in Hindi, so you understand in Hindi and laugh in English. So, Swamiji, pehle mai thi, phir shaadi hui, phir tu hi tu, phir kuch din gaye, phir kabhi mai, kabhi tu. Aur Swamiji, mai hu Gujarati, isiliye हूँ तू 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 हूँ तू 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 कबड्डी 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 धर्म क्षेत्रे कुरुक्षेत्रे समवेता ये सवा. See, relativity is possible only in duality. See, in the absolute, no relative problems exist. So, mama eva amshaha jiva loke. What happens in relativity? Jiva bhutaha. What is the meaning of becoming a jiva? That experience where the subject-object relationship is considered as real. Again, I repeat. That experience where subject-object relationship is taken to be real, that experience is called as jiva bhutaha. And when this happens, when consciousness expresses through the body as the mind, thereafter the knowledge is reduced from absolute to the relative and a sense develops that I is the knower and the not I is the known. This is called as jiva bhutaha. Now because of this, what happens? Because of this, there is always the following problems. First problem, I is limited by not I. Two, I being limited is always struggling for attaining perfection and completeness. Three, this limited I imagines, if I get the following not I's, I may attain perfection. And as a result, starts hugging and running after the not I's and is lost away from his own essential nature. This story is called as the jiva bhutaha. Now, sanatanaha, one word. But since how long this story is going on? Once I was in somebody's house and the child was extra smart. So, in the afternoon after food, I sleep. He says, Swamiji, I am not allowed to sleep unless you tell me a story. I said, okay, sit down. I said, I'll tell you the story, further you have to continue. Okay? Okay. I said, have you seen that big FCI godown? Yes, I have seen that. You know, it's packed from all sides? Yes. But there was one hole on the top. Is it? Yes. You have not seen? You are blind. I have seen. Then one sparrow came, entered, took one grain of rice and went out. Then the second sparrow came and entered, took the second grain of rice. Then I said, how long do you know counting, beta? So how many? I know up to 1,000. I said, continue. Isn't it? When was this world created? Oh God, why did you create me? God will never understand our language because he has not created anything. See? Please understand. Bhagavan has very clearly, distinctly, without any ambiguity, has told us in the fifth chapter what he says there. That I am not interested in any one of the things that you do. I am very clear about it. Because whether you are following the path of yoga or path of bhoga, it makes no problem to me. Na kartrutvam na karmani lokasya srujati prabhuhu. Na karma phala sanyogam swabhavastu pravartate. द सेंस ऑफ डुअरशिप इज नॉट द क्रिएशन ऑफ द लॉर्ड. कर्म इज नेवर क्रिएटेड बाय गॉड. एंड थर्ड, न कर्म फल संयोगम. वी डोंट बिकम मिजरेबल्स बिकॉज ऑफ द गॉड. व्हाई? वी आर सेल्फ सफिशियंट. स्वभावस्तु प्रवर्तते. व्हाई गॉड विल हैव टू कम मेक अस मिजरेबल? वी आर वेरी कंफर्टेबल विद दैट. फर्दर, ना दत्ते कस्यचित् पापं न चैवं सुकृतं विभुः. अज्ञानेनावृतं ज्ञानं तेन मुह्यन्ति जन्तवः. Whether you are following the path of righteousness or a path of sinful existence, you know what Lord says? Who cares? You suffer. See, our spiritual life is not to oblige to the Lord. Then this story is going on from eternity. One fallacy I'll tell you. Because of the karma, there is a jiva bhava. Because of the jiva bhava, there is a karma. Because of the karma, there is a jiva bhava. Because of the jiva bhava, there is a karma. Who is first? Egg or the poultry bird? See? Karya karan, cause and effect relationship, which is mutual dependence, is always supported by something which is independent. And therefore, mutually dependent relationship is an illusion. Once a father was scolding a son. I am made up of you. I gave you birth for this purpose. The son uach. The son said, Dad, enough is enough. Who told you that you created me? Now the father was afraid. I created you. How? Without me being born, who will call you dad? And therefore, as regard the age of the father and the son is concerned, it is same. Is it not? Bodily you may be old, but fatherly, you are 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. So father and son is a relative existence. But this man was there before he became a father, and he continues to be there if the son goes away. See? And therefore, sanatanaha, you cannot come to a final conclusion. When the jiva was born, it cannot be established. It is something like this. I want to learn swimming. But you know, without swimming, how can you jump into the water? Yes. But without jumping into the water, how can you swim? Then what is to be done? Take paper and draw notes. In the same manner, those who are not interested on the spiritual evolution, they have got millions of questions. They don't want to practice, only argument, logic. But why God has created this world? Who are you to ask, first of all? Second thing, why should I reply? You find out. And third, who told you God created this world? Did God come and tell you, excuse me, Mr. Deshpande? No, Marathis are very argumentative fellows. So, sanatanaha, this has eternally been like this. There is no reason behind this. See? Can you answer this question? When was the heat associated with the fire? See? Can we ask this question? When was the first wave born? These are all redundant questions. Therefore, mama eva amshaha jiva loke jiva bhutas sanatanaha. Expression of the absolute through the conditioning as the relative existence is an eternal phenomena. Nothing new about it. And further, after having attained the sense of limitation, then what we do? Then manashashtani indriyani prakriti sthani karshati. Now when you are in deep sleep, the whole gross world is not available to us. And how the gross world is available to us? Because of the five gateways. The flower is one. It is recognized by us in five different ways. Why? Because there are five sense organs. And a friend is no more a Swami. He was having eternal blockade of his nose because he has done too much of yoga. Eternal blockade. And he used to tell me, he said, he used to say, Swamiji, you know, I have progressed spiritually. I said, yes, very good. Do you know how? I said, I know, I don't know. You know, now for me, there are only four great elements. How come? My nose is blocked, so I never smell anything. Therefore, for all practical purposes, Prithvi Tattva doesn't exist for me. It is very true. The objective world becomes existent only if it is recognized through the sense organs. So, one object is recognized five different ways. And the moment one is divided into more than one, relativity is created. So this absolute reality, functioning through the conditioning of the body, starts expressing through the five gateways. Therefore, manashashtani indriyani, so the five sense organs and the mind. With this, now this limited expression of the infinite, prakriti sthani karshati, is naturally attracted towards objectivity. Be very attentive. If you go and sit in the window, you will naturally look outside. You don't go and sit in the window and from there you look inside the hall. No. Unless a special case is there. So, in the same manner, as long as we sit in the windows of our sense organs, we will be naturally extrovert. See, Kathopanishad says, Paranchikhani vyatruna svayambhu tasmat paran pashyati nantaratman kaschidhiraha pratyagatmanamaikshat avrutta chakshuhu amrutatvamichan. The Lord has created the faculties in such a manner, the moment you get associated with them, you are bound to be extrovert. See? Then there is but one rare seeker, kaschit dhiraha. And who is a seeker? Who has commitment, perseverance, courage and patience. Kaschit dhiraha. Pratyagatmanam aikshat. He is no more interested in the relative existence. Friends, unless we are able to get out of the enchantment of the relativity, we are far away from the truth. And as I told you, in the relative existence, there is no problem which has any permanent solution. No problem. It is always like that. So, this jiva, jiva bhuta sanatanaha, manashashtani indriyani, with the mind and the senses, identification with them, prakriti sthani karshati, we are naturally attracted towards the objective world. This is the story of Vandhyaputra. You know, Vandhyaputra means what? Vandhyaputra means son of a sterile woman. How it is possible? A sterile woman is the one who doesn't have children. And yet, yes, the word is there only. No meaning. See? Suppose I tell you, let us start all chanting the Lord's name. Brum bat, brum bat. What is this nonsense? Is this the Lord's name? Why? The sound which does not have a meaning is a nonsense. Isn't it? Jiva. It has no meaning. Not only that, Swamiji, what you know, Aham Brahmasmi, Aham has no meaning. Brahma has never meaning. Friends, words without meaning is a noise. The same way, we go on imagining that nobody said, Jiva is there, now, therefore, Papoham, Papa Karmaham. But we forget this is a story of a non-existing entity called as the Jiva. Therefore, please remember, I am emphasizing again and again, we do not want liberation from the world, from the miseries. We want liberation from this miserable I. Not liberation for I, but liberation from I. The moment this I disappears, everything is wonderful. See? When you divorce from your wife, what you do? That miserable husband disappears. Thereafter, ha ha hoo hoo, ananda hi ananda. In the same manner, the moment this jiva bhava disappears, there you are. Therefore, don't go too sentimentally into this story. So, Paramatma manifesting through the body as a living being gets associated with the mind, and the mind functioning through the sense organs develops five different faculties, and because of this is attracted towards the worldly objects. Prakriti sthani karshati. Thereafter, shariram yadavapnoti yachyatyut kramati shvaraha gruhitvaitani sainyatir vayurgandhani vashayat. Now, after having got attracted in the worldly objects, then the second phenomena begins. What is the second phenomena? Something we like, something we don't like. Now tell me, we all consider ourselves to be intelligent, scientific-minded people. You tell a small child, please take milk, I don't like milk, give me coffee. Now you ask him, why you don't like milk? I don't like. You ask me, why you don't like dhokla? There is no reason. You ask somebody, why do you like rasagulla? There is no reason. In short, liking and disliking has no reason. See? The famous story of Laila Majnu. Laila's father was disgusted and he told that Majnu, find out some beautiful girl, you are such a handsome man. My daughter is like a kabutar. Why are you after her? Leave her. You will get someone better than her. Majnu uvacha. Eternal words. Majnu says, to see the beauty of Laila, you require the squint eyes of the Majnu. What is the logic? There is no logic. Now many of you have fallen in love. Tell me what is the logic. That is why regrets. And for regrets also there is no logic. I don't know why I am regretting. Therefore, friends, this jiva, now what is jiva? Now please understand. Take an example. A bucket. In that bucket there is water, and the bucket is seated outside in the sun, and the sun reflects in that, and the disk of the sun is reflected in the water. The following phenomena takes place. First, in the general light of the sun, the bucket is illumined, the waters are illumined. General light. Second thing, on one particular spot in the water, the disk of the sun is reflected. And from there, another phenomena begins. A beam of reflected light goes away. And that beam of the reflected light also has the capacity to illuminate other things. But that reflected light cannot illuminate the sunlight. Now, that reflected light, what is the anatomy of that reflected light? Reflecting medium is required water. Two, original sun is required to reflect. Three, the reflection must appear in that water. Suppose water is inside the room and the sun is outside the room. But why there is no reflection in my bucket? Take your bucket of body with the waters of the mind and expose to the Lord. And when that mind water is pure, clean, undisturbed, the reflection of the Lord is identical. And the divinity starts manifesting through us. But if the bucket is like, the water is like what? First of all, you have taken the water and put this much of cow dung. Why? I have to do in the morning spreading everywhere. In that water with the cow dung, what will be the kind of reflection? And not only that, the water is disturbed, agitated. So the reflection will be broken into pieces. In the same manner, when the absolute reality is expressing through the limitations of the conditioning of the body and the mind and the senses, it cannot be a perfect and complete manifestation. In short, who is a jiva? Funny expression of the infinite through the finite conditioning is called as jiva. Take an example. Suppose your shoe number is 8 and you happen to put on the shoe which is one number less, whatever may be the reason. And you put on that shoe, it's a new one, I am going for a nice marriage and therefore I must go with proper shoes because the prosperity and the culture takes care more of the shoes than of the face. So the shoes are put on and then you go, come out of the car. And when you start climbing the steps, then you start feeling, my God, they're so tight. But you can't take out the shoes. Then what you start? Kauwa chala ham saki chal. Then you start walking like this thing. And I say, Guptaji, what's wrong with you? Nothing is wrong with me. But why are you walking like this thing? I'm walking all right. There's nothing wrong. And after some time, Guptaji goes to bathroom, removes the shoe. The same thing we all do. The infinite functioning through the limitation of one body, limitation of one pair of eyes, limitation of one pair of ears, limitation of a little mind, suffocates. And because of the suffocation, goes to the bathroom, where? In the deep sleep. And where? Everything is closed. Take out the shoes. Ha! Brahmanandam paramasukhadam. See? Therefore, and this is happening every day. This is happening to everybody. Whether human beings or animals. Therefore, this is a phenomena. This is not an individuality. So this individuality concept is an illusion. It is not real. I am body becomes a bondage when I limit that this body alone I am, then it is a bondage. If every body I am, like Bhagavan Krishna used to say. So, when those gopis reach him, or when our Draupadi Amma, when she reached, he reached her, oh, I am very hungry, give me food. So she took only one grain of rice, and all the Durvasas and the whole battalion of the rishis they were overfed. How it is possible? This is not jadu. See, is it not? Suppose I have got a pain in my small toe and very much painful. So somebody comes and does something there, presses or puts a medicine. I feel so good. See, because I am everywhere. In the same manner, that one reality, the absolute, is functioning in and through the totality. That is the truth. And this conditioned expression is in between state. That is not the reality. But we get enchanted by the story. So, manashashtan indriyani prakriti sthani karshati. And then what happens? No, like the children. And then what happened thereafter? Swamiji tell, no, I am very much interested to know. No, we'll see it after lunch. No lunch. In the same manner. What happens after death? First you die, we decided. So prakriti sthari karshati. Now, after having lived in this wretched body for many years, the jiva gets disgusted. This body is no more fit for me to live. Like electricity gets disgusted to stay in a fuse bulb. What is a fuse bulb? Shape remains the same. The capacity to allow the electrical energy to express as light, that capacity goes away. In the same manner, the capacity of the body to allow the expression of the consciousness as mind, when that capacity goes away, that body is called as dead. Nobody goes anywhere. But we are so buried in that, after death, wo mar ke chala gaya. Nobody goes nowhere. But now he has gone. And then our yogi mahatmas will tell, bhogis go by the lower door, yogis go by the upper door. See? Going and coming is for that which is considered as limited by time and space. Space doesn't go anywhere. Everything goes inside and outside the space. See? Now, this jiva, having found that the present body is not fit for expression of life, leaves the body. And then, shariram yadavapnoti, then he gets another body. So, continuity is there. Oh, good. And what kind of body he gets, depending upon what was the last thought in his mind. If the last thought before dying was, what will happen to my dog after I die? My dog. So last thought was the dog. Next life, wow. Because last thought makes the shape of the mind. Like a key and a lock. And when that mind with a firm shape comes out, is constantly searching for a right fit. And then enters into the another body. Isn't it sounding so enchanting? So the jiva comes out of this thing and goes into the another body. Isn't it? The jiva was an elephant. And the body became unfit. So the jiva left that body. But according to his karma, his next life was that of a mosquito. Now the jiva is frustrated. How to enter? How to enter? Because I am so huge. Friends, the huge sun enters the bucket of water or a dew drop without any problem. How he enters? As if enters, never enters. Reflection is an as if entry of the sun into the water, not real entry. Now after having got into another body, shariram yadavapnoti yachya utkramati, and thereafter he has done lot of papa punya, and there he has gathered lot of good and bad karmas, and then he leaves that body also, and then utkramati, then he discards that body. After having discarded the body, he goes to the next body, then again he dies, then he goes to the next body, and then how many counting, you know? Keep on going. See? So, and who is this? Now see the words. Ishwaraha, be very attentive. That which is called as Jiva is basically Ishwara. See? Our Bundoko Manicha tells in a mantra, द्वा सुपर्णा सयुजा सखाया समानं वृक्षं परिशश्वजाते तयोः अन्यः पिप्पलं साधुमत्ति अनश्नन् अन्यः अभिचाकशीति. ऑन द ट्री ऑफ द बॉडी आर सीटेड टू बर्ड्स वेरी क्लोज फ्रेंड एंड लुक एग्जैक्टली अलाइक लाइक द मोदी जिरॉक्स एग्जैक्टली. Sayuja sakhaya, samanam rukshaṁ parishashva jāte, as if hugging each other. And out of the two, anyaha pippalam swadumatti, he is enjoying the fruits on the tree. And when the fruit is good, he is fluttering his wings. And when the fruit is bitter, he is getting frustrated. What the other bird is doing? Anashnan. He doesn't get involved into relativity. Then what he does? He watches the tamasha of the dancing dolls. Now, who is Ishvara? Ishvara is the one who illuminates but doesn't get influenced. And who is the Jiva? Who illuminates and gets influenced. So we are simultaneously Jiva as well as Ishvara. If the limitations of the conditionings influence us, then only the thoughts will come. I think I have to die and go. My time has come. Please understand, if any one of us gets even a passing thought in our mind, ab marna hi achha, is better to die. Or a thought comes, I think one day I have to die and go. All your spirituality has gone to dogs. Please understand this. The thought of death and the thought of birth is the highest bluff in all the religions. Get out of that. To tell this is this topic. So shariram yadavapnoti yachyati utkramati ishvaraha. Now who is he? Is Ishvara. And because he is Ishvara, what he does? Shrotram chakshusparasharam cha rasanam ghranam eva cha. All the faculties he carries with him from the present body to the next body. See, when you go to the big hotel and when you are living, you cannot carry all the drapery and the bed sheets and the towels with you. You have to leave them there. But when this Jiva, when he leaves the present body, he carries with him Shrotram Chakshusparacharam cha Rasanam Ghranam eva cha. All the faculties carry with him. Like what? That Vayur Gandhani Vashaya. Just like the air carries the fragrance or the dirty smell along with it when it flows. And then what happens? Then adishthaya manaschayam vishayan upasevate. Then again the same Jiva with the faculty of mind functioning through the sense organs again start experiencing the same five objects, and in this manner the Jiva goes from one body to another body. See the story, please understand, is the most difficult story of life. That day I told you, I don't remember, the story of the three pot makers. Did I tell you the story? No? Listen, this is the one of the most enchanting story written by Sant Eknath Maharaj. He writes, on the tip of a thorn were situated three villages. Two were without population, one was useless, not a single person was living. In among the three, there was one village where there were three pot makers living. Two were dead, one was not alive. And that pot maker has made three pots. And the three pots were not cooked, other was just broken before making. Now that pot maker had three sons. Two were born dead, one was aborted. Now these sons took these three pots and crossed the three rivers to reach the market. And the three rivers were, two were dry, in one there was no water. And afterwards they reached that market. And then he sold these three pots to the three people. And he got the 3 rupees. Two were fake and one was never useful. Aaya samajh mein? This is the story of the jiva. See, there Sant Eknath Maharaj says, if you understand it, you are wise. If you don't understand, don't feel bad. Go to Guru Maharaj and ask from him, sir, what is the meaning of this story? And this story is this jiva story. Now see, the one, be very attentive, who leaves the present body and goes into another body, carrying with him all the faculties in the mind, is he not Ishvara? See, when I go out from my house with my purse in my hand, I am not called as a thief, is it not? Because I am the Ishvara, I am the boss, I am the owner. But I feel so innocent when I go to somebody's house, I just lift the purse and go out. No, not allowed. In the same manner, when I go out of the present body and carry with me my faculties with me, therefore I am the Ishvara. What happens to this Ishvara when he is leaving the body, becoming slave of the sense organs? See? Becoming victim of the weaknesses of the mind? Therefore, Ishvara is reduced to jiva when he is enslaved by the senses and the mind. So discover that you are the boss. Life will be totally different. And when you have thus conquered your faculties, your mind, how to do that? For that, yoga abhyas required. But don't stop there. Many of us have got this funny notion, if I can sit in a particular posture for a long period of time, yoga. Afterwards, call the fire brigade, tow me out because I can't open now. Please understand, that is not all. Or doing the different types of acrobatics. I remember our Swamiji was asked by somebody a long time back, Swamiji, you know, you should talk in your lecture about yoga. And what is the meaning of yoga? Only asana, that's it. That's normally yoga fellow mean that only. So he just brushed the question. But that fellow was after him, like Dokla is after me. Yesterday, can you believe? I went to a Sindhi house for food and along with water, what they could do, not papad, Dokla. I said, you know, people have got Shani, Ravi, Mangal in their kundali, in my kundali there is Dokla. Comes. So, see, this world is so beautiful. So when we are able to control our senses, mind, that is the purpose of the yoga abhyas. So when our Swamiji was told, why don't you do this, why don't you do this, he told in very clear terms, I don't believe in twisting the body. I believe in straightening the mind. How simple it is. When the mind is straight, relativity disappears. When the mind is crooked, relativity appears. It is not. When the sun rays go straight, it is immaculate white. When the same sun ray goes through the prism of individuality, the vibhayoric pattern of seven colors, sa-re-ga-ma-pa-da-ni-sa, along with the sound and the color, the whole world of plurality is born. Therefore, what is required for us to understand that the story of Jiva is this. If we feel limited, it is only because we are slaves of our senses and the mind. Win over them, ride over them. Yoga rudasya tasyaiva shamaha karana uchyate. The one who is yoga rudha, who he is seated steadfast on the steed of this yoga, who yadahi nendriyarteshu na karmasu anushajyate. When we are no more victims of our senses and no more attached to the worldly activities, then alone we have attained real control over us. And friends, when you take possession, charge of the whole affair of life, then you come to know that you are not limited behind these eyes as the seer, but you are the one seeing through all the eyes. In bhakti marga, this is called as sarvatmya bhava. We do only bhavana. Whosoever comes in my life is none other than my Krishna. So we do only bhavana. Here, no bhavana. It is sarvatmya bodha. It is the experience. Bhavana can get corrupted. Bodha will never get corrupted. See, when you are a master of driving, you can drive every car. In the same manner, the moment you discover that you are not the expressions, but you are the one that is expressing, this understanding is discovery of the truth. So, adhishthaya manashchayam vishayan upasevate. So earlier, in our earlier form, we were seeing through the eyes. In the present form, we see through the eyes. In the earlier form, we were smelling through the nose. In the present form, we smell through the nose. Because what is inside is the same, no difference. And in this manner, Vishayan Upasevate, the bhoga and story continues. And then utkramantam sthitam vapi bhunjanam va gunanvitam. Now here is the catch. Utkramantam, while living the body, sthitam, while living inside the body, and third, bhunjanam va gunanvitam, when in contact with the worldly objects and enjoying or suffering. Be attentive. Bhagavan says, vimudha ananupashyanti. Who is the vimudha? There are three categories. One is, I told you yesterday, one is moodha, second is amoodha, and third is vimoodha. So mood is the base. And when the foolishness departs for good, is amoodha. And when the foolishness is maintained, nurtured, watered, and taken care of, it is vimoodha. Vimoodha is the one who does not want to change his vision. See? Our Kaivalyopanishad says, na karmanana prajaya dhanena tyage naike amrutatva manashu. Tyaga, renunciation of what? Wrong notions. One wrong notion is that I am the body. Second wrong notion is that I am rich and poor. Third wrong notion is I am a Hindu and Muslim. Fourth wrong notion is I am a desh bhakta and others are desh bhokta. All wrong notions has to be given up. Up to what level? I am the Jiva. See? Long time back, our Swami Akhandanji says in some places, when he had not taken sannyas, he was speaking Bhagavat Mahapuran to one great Avadhut Maharaj, a great master. So after listening to him for 15 days, then he said, look here, I have been hearing Bhagavat from you and I am supposed to give you something. I should not take it free. But I am a Avadhut, I have nothing. What can I give you? Okay, now I give you. Listen. And he was told, never, never accept that you are a Jiva, a soul, an ego. You are that Parabrahma Paramatma, the absolute reality. Swami Akhandanandji says, from that moment onward, I never had even an inkling that relativity is real. See, that is the ultimate. Otherwise, do this thing, do that thing, and then you get lot of powers, and when you become powerful, you are liberated. No, the more the power you have, the more useless you become. See? And therefore, here Bhagavan is telling, Utkramantam, living the body, living inside the body, enjoying this thing, Vimudhanan Upashanti. Those who are obsessed with the wrong vision, they are unable to recognize the absolute reality behind the relative expression. See? Those who are obsessed with directions, there are many people. When you sleep, you should not face your legs to the south, you should face your legs to the north, or you should do this thing, that thing. And when you sleep, you must have seen your children like the clock, they move all around. Where is your direction? See? Similarly, other type of people obsess too much with the different kind of muhurta. Third kind of people obsess with different kinds of graha, but the duragraha they don't want to leave. See, please remember, hold on to this absolute vision. In this absolute vision, you have attained everything. In the end, Bhagavan will say, etat buddhva buddhiman syat krita krityascha bharat. And what is that? Buddhva. You have to simply recognize, that's it. Don't do anything. Enough we have done in this world. By doing only we are suffering. Now all spiritual practice is undoing and unbecoming. See? So vimudhanan upashanti. Because we are so much involved in this relative world. You talk to the people, you know. When they are, sometimes they come, most of the time, you know, nothing but complaints and frustrations. One day one person came, Swamiji, will you please help me? I said, what is that? If you want money, I'm sorry. I never give money. I accept only. You know? Mine is a Lena bank, not a Dena bank. Dena is your bank. No, no, Swamiji, actually, you know, I am having a problem with my wife. Lucky. Why? Only with your wife? He says, Swamiji, you are pulling my leg. I said, no. What is the problem? Problem is, she doesn't understand anything. I said, then where is the problem? No problem. It is difficult to talk to you. I said, don't talk. I said, look here, who told you to get married? Did I tell you? No. So, who told you? You go to him. Don't come to me. Friends, please remember this very simple thing. Vimudha nanu pashanti. Why they don't see? Too much obsessed with the world. And we all know, see, what is most wonderful part is, वाइज पीपल लर्न फ्रॉम द एक्सपीरियंसेस ऑफ अदर्स, अदरवाइज पीपल डोंट लर्न इवन फ्रॉम देयर ओन एक्सपीरियंसेस. सी द बेसिक डिफरेंस. सो वाइज पीपल लर्न फ्रॉम द मैरिजेस ऑफ अदर्स, इज़न्ट इट? And the otherwise people, they not only they got married, they get their children also married. See? Focus attention on something higher. Why they are vimudha nanu pashyanti? What is the mudhatva? Mudhatva, foolishness is this. We are so obsessed, first. Second thing, we take only partial view of our life. And want to come to a complete conclusion, it will never be possible. See, our life is not only in the waking world, we also have experiences in the dream, in the deep sleep. How much weightage we have given in analyzing our total life to the other two areas of experience, as if waking experience is the total experience? No. This thought I gave you a few days back. Contemplate on this. You will be liberated from yourself. One day, one air hostess came after her marriage. Swamiji, you could not come for a marriage, therefore I have come to take your blessing. And I had one Rudraksha that day in my hand. Normally I don't keep anything, that day it was there. So I said, okay, take this Rudraksha, put around your neck. So it was put. Now I said, may this Rudraksha protect you from yourself. He said, Swami, what is funny kind of blessing? I said, I am a funny person and you are an air hostess, super funny. See, Atmaiva Atmano Bandhu, Atmaiva Ripura Atmanaha. Therefore, again and again, think about this project which I am giving you. We have gone through many, many dreams, but never a dream personality is crystallized. One dreamer has no relationship with the other dreamer. Is it not? So also, we have gone through many waking experiences. Our waking experience is not a continuous experience. Like the dream begins and ends, so also waking experience begins and ends. Therefore, they are discontinuous experiences. If the discontinuous dream experiences do not crystallize a continuous personality called as the ego, on what ground do we accept that the discontinuous experiences of the waking world can crystallize into a continuous personality? Now think logically. See, you have no ground. Then where from the continuity comes? Sutre Manigana Iva, Bhagwan told us. There is a continuous thread, the consciousness, which is not only supporting the waking, but waking, dream, deep sleep, samadhi, everything. All of them come and go. If we are able to recognize this continuum of our experience, then you will come to know that as the waking comes, dances goes away. The dream comes, dances goes away. The deep sleep comes, sits goes away. But I continue to be undisturbed, eternal presence. Then what happened to that jiva? See? Vimudhana anupashanti. Pashanti jnana chakshushaha. Our question is like, one cat took the the wool ball from her mistress, owner, and playing, and in that play the ball got undone and the cat got entangled and worried, now boss will come and she will fire me. What I have done to the ball? Where the ball has gone? Isn't it? Where the jiva has gone? Find out. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Mahatma, wait for a moment.